As Arvind takes the pride of making world-class products, it is very important to have a robust QA structure where the customer receives the right product at the right time. It is very important to have world-class manufacturing units so that the process and the systems are set right. So, to ensure that the process and the systems are working at the factory, the QA has to ensure that these systems are working for them as well as a right product goes to the customer. So, the QA goes to various departments, right from fabric, trim stores, cutting, CAD, sewing section, finishing, packing, so that he has a total control of the processes and the systems where the manufacturing units are adhering to. As well as we at Arvind have certain standards where all the quality parameters have to be met. The factory assessments is basically done on QMS principles. QMS is nothing but quality management systems where we talk about management commitment, resource management, product realization, measurement analysis, and finally continuous improvement. So all these areas would be taken up separately and the assessment would be done against a factory.
Factory assessment will be conducted starting of every season. So during this assessment, all the department and the SOPs and practices of the factory will be covered. So once the assessment is completed, the non-conformance and observations will be shared with the factory concerned person and head of the department. So company is supposed to come with the action plans and supporting documents to clear this. So after completing the assessment, the documents will be shared with the quality department, head of the quality department, as well as sourcing team. After factory assessment, we come to know the factory performance and we can categorize the factories based on that. So once we categorize the factories, depend on the category, we can decide the order quantity and the style. So where to place and which company to choose.
Fabric department. In this department, the QA basically looks at a different process so that the product is adhering to Arvind standards. In this process, he basically verifies the goods which are being in-house has been verified against the PO copy, how much material has been in-house, as well as all the material has been mapped properly and kept. Mapping is very important so that the traceability can be done easily. The next important thing is the shrinkage bits and the shades have been clearly identified and segregated. Also, the rejected fabrics have to be quarantined. So this is the basic systems what he looks at, and also a very important aspect of fabric department is a 4-point check system has been done. As per Arvind standard, if it's a wash program, 100% inspection has to be done across all the rolls, or he can follow 10% of the rolls have been inspected so that there are no fabric flaws which are flowing into the sewing section. This ensures that the systems are intact in the fabric department.
ALBL QA initially checks the fabric inward process. All inward materials are checked against the PO copy. He has to verify fabric inspection reports and factory's internal checking process. Here the QA is verifying the 4-point system of checking each roll against the records. The QA has to check the mapping of racks. This ensures easy traceability and industry's best practice. He checks the record of shades, shrinkages, fabric combination card approved by merchant across the received fabrics. QA verifies quarantine areas for rejected fabrics. He has to check for shrinkage process, GSM process and fabric relaxation process. All approved shades to be checked in light box. All records will be verified and deviations will be noted by the QA.
In trim stores, the QA basically verifies the inward goods. against the PO and the bill of materials. And also it is very important that all the Arvind products trims have been stacked up separately with style numbers and PO numbers. So this ensures that the traceability is done, and also the tapes which are being in-house has to be pre-shunk so that it will be easy for the sewing department. And it is also very important that the trim stores get all the trim cards getting approved through the concerned merchant. And also the nominated QA verifies those trims against the bill of materials and PO copy and sign it off, so that prior to the bulk production, these trim cards will be the reference as a standard for manufacturing.
The QA has to verify records of in-house material against DC and PO copy. It is critical that 10% of in-house trims are verified for quality checks under proper lighting. All materials are mapped with respective style code, PO number, and quantities stored against each rack for easy traceability. All packing trims must be approved by merchant before bulk execution, and a copy of trim card has to be issued to the sewing department and packing section. Draw cord, elastic and zipper has to be pre-shrinked before issuing to production. Quarantine areas for rejected trims is mandatory. The QA has to verify record keeping and note any deviations observed.
Cutting has to be done 100%. So in the cutting department also, we used to do random inspections as a bundle inspections, where the cut panel is supposed to match to the original patterns. In the original patterns, the points which we actually cross-check is, one is the pattern number which they followed. As per our technical team provided Arvind brands, they're supposed to follow the same thing. And after that, they need to follow the shrinkage percentages. They need to cross-check the shrinkage of the fabric lot by lot. Based on that, if it is required, they need to change the pattern lot by lot. Otherwise, they can continue use the patterns as it is.
All patterns have to be placed at designated area with identification. Every lay marker should be mentioned with style number, part name, size, cut number and shrinkage. During cut panel inspection, QA needs to check randomly for panel accuracy, compare the pattern of the top, middle and bottom of each bundle, and any deviation needs to be recorded. 100% panel inspection has to be done. The QA verifies the inspection reports. ALBL QA also verifies the lux required at checking area. The lighting requirement has to meet the industry standard. Recutting and end bits track record to be available, and QA has to verify the same. Fabric defects has to be displayed at panel checking area. All cut panels and end bits have to be stored at designated area with proper identification.
The very important thing in cutting section is the fusing. The fusing parameters have to be checked against time, temperature, pressure, and it has to be checked at regular intervals. This ensures that the product has been fused rightly, because we can't reject the garments once the garments have been manufactured completely. So the process and the controls have to be looked upon by the QA at various stages.
QA has to verify the fusing machine calibration, which is displayed on fusing machine. Time, temperature, pressure has to be verified every 2 hours. QA to check the right interlining usage as per approved strike-off. Bond strength has to be checked before and after wash. He has to also verify the machine maintenance records and note the findings during his assessment. CAD, computer-aided design. CAD department has to ensure right shrinkage patterns are issued to production floor. This impacts the measurements, as every roll has different shrinkages. Also, the control spec has to be sealed off from the central CAD department. Factory to have only the final signed off controlled spec. Any patterns issued to the batch should be verified and sealed by pattern master. All patterns must be stored at designated area with identification.
Sewing department is a key area where the raw materials would be converting into garments. The QA has to focus on various processes at regular intervals. This can be done through inline checking at regular intervals, endline checking where the complete product is being sewn in, and it is also very important that critical marks have been displayed and the standards are being met as per that critical marks. The QA does an inline review and also the endline review during this process. In the sewing section, it is also important that all the approved standards have been agreed during the pre-production meeting. The QA has to verify that all the reports are being generated at an hourly basis, and also these comments have been taken care during the bulk production. He also must verify that the trim cards have been displayed at the section along with the PP meeting comments, so that any issues that rise during the production can be verified against those points.
Standards and method of operation needs to be set for every critical operation for easy understanding of the operator. Operation bulletin, line design, trim card has to be displayed at end table. Stitches per inch, needle size, seam allowance, special folder, if any, has to be displayed as a mock. Numbering stickers not to be pasted on machine tops. There should be clear identification of bins for pass and altered garments. Iron tables have to be clean and the cloth on pressing table has to be changed on weekly basis. QC to maintain records on hourly inspection findings. Any alerts to be raised at the early stage of production. QA to verify all records of inline and endline. It is the supervisor's responsibility to address the issues and resolve. Maintenance. Oil levels to be below high level. This avoids excess leakage of oil through needle bar. Also, it is important the machine oil tank is neat and clean. Needle policy is critical. QA has to verify stock keeping and issue records of needles. He must also verify records of broken needle log and missing needle log book. This ensures prevention of metal contamination in garment.
Finishing department majorly consists of four sections: trimming section, ironing section, final presentation section, measurement section, and then finally it goes for packing. The QA has to ensure that all the inline reports are being generated on an hourly basis and certain action is being taken upon the reworked garments or rejected garments. It is also very important that the QA verifies all the measurement records have been maintained. As a standard, the nominated QA has to verify 3 garments per hour to meet the spec requirement. And during the final presentation checking, it is very important that the standards have been displayed, like pressing standard. The packing approval has to be taken prior to packing of the lot, and also a trim card has to be verified and signed by the QA, which the QA also verifies it at the end of the section.
Buttoning section in charge has to make the keyhole and button on the first piece and compare with the counter sample. Button pull test to be conducted on daily basis. Pull test must pass 17 lbs for 10 seconds. Sealed PP samples needs to be displayed in the finishing section. Iron standard has to be displayed for easy reference. Measurement checker need to check all the garment for critical points of measurement and record. Rejected garments quantity details record should be maintained and corrective action plan has to be actioned upon. All tags should be displayed in packing sections. Trim card has to be duly signed by quality assurance manager. ALBL QA has to verify inline reports, measurement reports, and order completion reports, and makes a note of his observations during the assessment. Post-tagging of trims and packaging, the QA has to ensure the first box audit is being conducted. This verifies the carton dimension, marking and count of each garments in the carton. It is the responsibility of the nominated QA to do an interim audit for every 500 pieces packed.
First packing, they are supposed to be take packing approval from the brands. Against the packing approval, I'm going to cross-check the packing requirement and as per my packing trims requirement. So once it is completed, everything is fine, they can start their bulk packing. Once bulk packing starts, first box audit will be conducted from the buyer QA and NQA is supposed to be there with us. It is completed, then we will start the final audit.
Handover meeting external. External handover will happen at factory location. The meeting would be presided by factory management, ALBL sourcing and field QA. The QA discusses the brand comments and critical areas of concern for each style.
Post handover meeting, the QA does the risk assessment. Risk assessment is nothing but a brainstorming session along with the category heads where he clearly defines the areas of critical issues that occur in the product. It also gives an indication that the QA forecasts an issue and highlights it in his record so that there will be smooth execution of the style in the production. It's basically a heads-on that he is intimating the production team as well as the sourcing team, where we can have a chance of getting an approval prior bulk execution. Based on the risk analysis, the product will be classified into high, medium and low. The main advantages of risk assessment is the factory technical team will be knowing the risks prior to the bulk execution so that major issues can be avoided during the bulk execution. Caveat is warning. If someone adds caveat, it is understood that you have to be aware of something which is very critical. A caveat report is generated by the QA mentioning all the comments which are bound to happen during the production. A caveat report is submitted to the product team, the sourcing team, that the quality standard might have some issues during bulk execution.
Size sets. ALBL QA has to review the size sets against SMS sample and have to see the handover comments. Risk assessment comments are incorporated. The workmanship of the product has to meet the standards. He has to measure all garments and ensure the specs are hit right. He reviews tech details as per the spec requirements and ensure all approvals are taken prior to execution of bulk. If the size sets are not meeting the standard, he rejects them and factory has to ensure for a resubmission. PP sample review. PP sample demonstrates manufacturing capability before start of production. This ensures that all factors of raw material, machinery, operator skill and environment can achieve ALBL expectations in bulk production. This also demonstrates manufacturing capability prior to production start and ensure product conformance in production. QA has to review the PP sample against the style file. Style file is a compiled file consisting of all the related documents right from purchase order, bill of materials, tech packs, control spec sheets, mini marker, raw material approvals, trim card approvals, sample review comment sheets, necessary approvals based on styling like print strike off, embroidery strike off. he must make sure the review sheet covers all details of his findings. He also identifies areas of improvement and then seals the garment with a green seal. The PP sample will be handed over to the factory team.
In the PP meeting, we discuss about the requirements of the product. So based on the comments from the brands and the buyer, so we have started doing the PP meeting.
Pre-production meeting is a mandatory critical event. It is a meeting with all cross-functional teams of factory to understand the product requirement and also the process required to ensure smooth flow of style execution. Production manager has to ensure all clarifications are being taken up before the bulk execution. It is also important he gives the right instructions to the entire production team. ALBLQA reviews line design, which includes targets, production per machine, needle size, thread, work aids, profiles, folders, guides, notches at cutting stage, and looks at any simplification in construction. Pre-production meeting reports has to be filed in the QA file, which includes PPM checklist, duly signed by attendees, fabric in charge, store in charge, cutting in charge, pattern technician, embroidery or printing in charge, head mechanic, industrial engineer, buttoning in charge, finishing in charge, packing in charge, supervisor, QC, product safety in charge, merchandiser, factory manager, production manager, quality assurance manager.
In audits, we have got different stages, like what we say as inline audits, interim audits, final audits. The main purpose of quality audits being done by QA is to ensure that the product is being consistently manufactured across the whole order quantity. It is also important that the right feedback is given at the right time for the manufacturing unit so that they will take certain action and correct the product during the process. Post PP meeting, it is very important that an agreed date of pilot review has to be agreed upon with the manufacturing unit. During this process, the QA visits the line and he reviews the initial 25 pieces which have been manufactured against the approved gold seal sample. This ensures that the product has been rightly set with all the machineries as agreed upon in the PP meeting. The second stage of audit would be in the finishing section, where he again reviews 25 pieces once the goods get packed. During this process, it is the responsibility of the manufacturing unit to take the right approvals. Post packing, QA approval gives an approval on the packing pieces. It is important that the factory calls on first box audit, where he reviews all the packing standards and the carton standards.
First box audit should be done color-wise as soon as the first box is packed. QA to review labeling, packing instructions, hang tag, barcode placement, folding instructions, carton weight, marking and count of the garments in the carton.
And then later on, once the quantities get ready, it is important that he offers for an interim audit.
Before start the final audit, the one thing is I need to conduct interim audit within the factory where the goods are packed more than 50% or below 50% by the time. If any issues, we need to note down that and we will concern to a person we are going to inform to correct the things.
AQL is acceptance quality limit. It is defined as the quality level that is worst tolerable. Through AQL, we will come to know what is the sample size to be picked up, and also what is the maximum number of defects to be accepted. At Arvind Lifestyle Brands, we do for AQL 1 as well as for AQL 2.5. For all formal wear, we do for AQL 1, and for all wash programs, we do AQL 2.5. We have a measuring chart which defines what is the minimum acceptable level and the maximum acceptable level of defects.
For the smooth conduct of final audits are required are, one is inline audit, interim audit, and the packing 100% packing audit requirements are required, which is conducted by the company. So once it is completed, for the final audit, the documents or requirements is, one is style file, which is completed by all the approvals, and the FPT and GPT, and PP samples are required. So if these kind of things are there, so we can conduct smooth final audit with the OCR report, where the company need to debrand the rejected garments. So then we can cross-check the rejected garments, then we'll conduct the final audit.
Final audits has to be verified against packing approvals, tags, workmanship, styling. The QA has to audit as per AQL and has to report the same. All audit findings have to be discussed with the factory management and should insist for a corrective action plan. Post the audit, he seals the report and a hard copy is handed over to factory. This signals for dispatching goods to the warehouse.
At the warehouse, a QA picks up 20 pieces against each style and he verifies the quality standards. If the quality standards are not being met, an intimation would be going to the category head of quality as well as the sourcing head. During this process, it will be decided whether the goods have to be returned back to the vendor or the goods can be inverted. If the audit fails, the QA has to review the defective pieces with the factory and work on a root cause analysis so that these defects are not being repeated during the next audit. Once the goods are shipped from factory, the goods reach the respective warehouse. It is the responsibility of the factory to ship the goods in proper cartons and in good condition. The goods have to be transported in a closed container. Once the goods reach the warehouse, the security checks the inward documents and receives the cartons. The warehouse QA will randomly pick 20 pieces audit for each style code. He verifies the product quality in terms of aesthetics and presentation. If the consignment passes the AQL level, the goods will be sent for 100% GRN. If the goods fail AQL level, it will be intimated to the sourcing and category manager. Once a decision is taken, the goods will be returned back to vendor for rechecking. The field QA has to work on corrective action plan on the same with the factory. He has to ensure that the defects are not being repeated. Debranding is related to brand image protection. It is also very important that the surplus goods which are being manufactured has to be accounted for, and the nominated QA has to verify all the records and he has to go ahead as per the debranding policy of Arvind.
Main label on the product shall be mutilated. In case of heat transfer sticker as main label, it shall be debranded with permanent ink stamp. Branded tag, price tag, and any other tags shall be cut and removed from the product.
During the entire manufacturing process, the QA would be interacting with the factory management at various stages. It is very important for him to maintain his cool and dignity while dealing with any conflicts. And also, all the comments given by the QA as well as the factory management has to be taken up positively. During any of the conflict, the issues are beyond resolution, the QA has to escalate to the senior management. The QA has to ensure right information is being communicated at the right time, as well as the while dealing with the factory management, it has to be a win-win situation so that this conflict resolutions will not occur on a day-to-day basis.
Hello, good evening, sir.
What good evening, yeah? See here. See the pieces, sir, how badly
down,
they pack.
Cool down. That is the reason I came here.
How can I pass these governments?
Since it is a C zone, this can be accepted as a minor. This also minor, this also minor, this also minor. It should be accepted, this conjoint.
On what basis you are telling like that?
So nobody will see at the bottom.
The presentation sir, area where you, the customer sir, can find out
sir,
the things.
Sir, you go anywhere, this problem will come. This problem bound to come.
So you are not a person to decide this kind of, okay?
Sir,
you don't teach me on this. I am not going to do any audit at all. You do yourself.
Good evening, sir. How are you?
Hi, Kumar.
How was the day?
Good. It was good, yeah.
How things are going?
So many defects I found at a final inspection, Kumar.
Okay.
So which I cannot consider as a pass.
Okay. Okay.
Just
okay.
Go through this.
Okay, let me check. This also minor, this also minor, this also minor. Sir, since all are minor, this can be accepted.
So many pieces I found within the AQ level. Where I found, you know, definitely it is going to affect my customer.
Okay.
So please recheck few more pieces.
Okay.
So let me know what is the rejection level or a defective percentage. We can escalate the issue to next level.
Okay.
We can resolve this issue.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for your cooperation.
How can you dispatch the goods which is failed for quality issues?
Sir, because of some month-end urgency, we take an approval from your sourcing team and we dispatch the goods, sir.
You're supposed to inform me first.
No, sir. Already we taken approval from your sourcing team through mail.
Now warehouse guys are asking
sir,
what
they,
to do.
They given approval from mail through, sir. Based on that, we can dispatch the goods.
Next time, we'll see how you are going to dispatch goods like this.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Hello, master.
Hi, sir.
Morning, I got a call from warehouse. One goods actually dispatched without inspection report. Why?
So we worked up to midnight. Because of urgency, we dispatched the goods. See, we take an approval from your sourcing team, sir.
But actually, you're supposed to inform, you know, first before you dispatch the
sir,
goods.
Sir, that's the reason I'm writing mail to you, sir.
Warehouse guys are calling and asking me.
So next time, it will not happen like
that. I do one thing.
Okay.
This time, I'm escalate this issue to next level.
Right, sir.
Okay. So next time, should not repeat it.
No,
okay?
Problem.
So take okay. care. Next
yes,
time,
sir.
Don't repeat.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, what's happening? What's happening in your factory?
Sir, I'm in a meeting. Please wait.
Without PP, people have started production. Now you are asking me to wait. Without PP, how can you start the bulk production?
Sir, already my factory line, sir, is going on idle. That's what I've taken sourcing approval, no?
See, we are not here to fulfill your factory lines and all. We need our SOP to be followed. Okay? I'm not coming for any inline entry audit and all.
No, now the samples are ready. You please read it and give me now.
I'm not coming to your factory itself, okay? You just keep your production here only. I'm leaving this. Sorry for the disturbance, sir. I observed that, you know, you are starting production without PP sample approval. This is not a proper SOP follow.
No. But our factory lines is idle. That's what I taken approval.
But we have a major concerns in this style particularly. There is a lot of comments from the brands. So you need to rectify it.
Okay.
Otherwise, your goods will be rejected.
Okay, sir. Our technical team will talk with our
please,
team only.
Please do
okay.
it and don't repeat again.
Yeah,
you need to follow.
Okay. Sure.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
What is this, master? This many problems are coming. I commented on PP. You're not following the PP comments.
No. This is the maximum level we can able to achieve this fabric. You know, this is the fabric is very thin. So this is the
maximum. See, I'm not here to listen all your reasons. I want as for my PP sample.
Okay.
Otherwise, you stop the line.
No. I'm not going to stop the line. Why I have to stop the line? I'm not going to stop the line.
From past two seasons, I'm seeing your peoples are not improving. I'll see how you are going to dispatch these goods. And next time, your orders will be cancelled.
No, I'm not going to stop the line. Do whatever you want.
What is this, master? This problem actually I already informed the PP meeting. Still it is coming.
No, sir. This is actually initial pieces. What is output is 20-50 pieces. So we are going to make correct in the next production, sir.
See, whatever output is came, defective pieces should be rectified.
Sure.
Rework and
sure.
Repack it.
Definitely.
Okay.
I'll show you one piece rectified and I'll show you one piece.
I'll check that pieces.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Don't repeat it.
Yeah, I'll show you one piece.
Inform to your NQC and QC, sir.
Yeah, rectified and I'll show you all the pieces.
What is this, yeah? Why this quantity is very less? How you pack this one?
I think so, some mistake happened, sir. I'll cross check and I'll let you know.
Call that idiot. Who is the pack this one? Simply you people are wasting my time. Why are you calling for inspection, sir? Keep this one. What is this, sir? Quantity is half of the quantity packed. Why it is happening?
It's a mistake happened. I will check and I will let you know, sir.
See, if goods are not ready, don't call for inspection and educate your operators to pack properly. Okay?
Yes,
so right now I am giving abort report. This issue will be escalated to my seniors and your seniors also.
Okay?
Don't repeat this one.
Okay.
Hi sir, what is the issue?
See the pieces, Kumar.
No, don't throw the pieces. Tell me, sir, what happened?
See the critical pieces. I never seen in my experience this kind of critical issues.
I'll bet you your company will not going to work another 5 months.
Don't speak about factory.
You're going to shut down your company.
What is the factory? How you are doing?
This is not a way of working. Yeah, I know how you people are practicing in a quality department.
No, don't talk about company. I know.
Risking all these goods and giving.
No, I will not risk in the goods.
Why?
No, this is not major issue. You can accept it, no?
This is a critical issue.
No.
I'm not going to.
No.
I'll say how you are going to dispatch this course. I'll pack up this
one.
I'm not going to allow this one.
No, I know how to ship the goods.
I'll not going to allow this one.
Hello, sir. What is the issue?
See the problematic pieces, dear Kumar. In your company, how they are packed.
Okay.
I never seen this kind of problematic pieces in my experience.
Okay. Sir, I don't think so. This is the problem.
See, Kumar, this is
can be accepted.
Very critical area, what I am pointing out.
Okay.
So, this is actually in the interest of our customer requirement.
Okay.
And as well as brand requirement.
Okay.
This will be useful to your company also. Company will be improved in the quality aspect.
Okay.
Just take care on this and reskin it on QV.
Please help me this time. Definitely, we will improve in next lot.
It's not possible, Kumar. This is a critical zone, what I am saying. Please do the rescreen. Or else we can go to the higher level.
Okay, we'll reskin and re-offer it.
Okay, thank you for cooperation. So if you do the same cooperation to the quality and the brand, your company will be improved.
Thank
you. It's a benefit for your company only.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Now that we have seen different scenes of conflict resolution, it is very important for the QA neither to be passive nor to be aggressive. Rather, he has to be very collaborative with the factory management. The interaction with the factory team will be happening at different levels, at the floor with the management. So the QA has to ensure he builds trust with them, and it will be a win-win situation for both the QA as well as the factory.